Welcome to this session, another new session. In this session, we will see tank sluice. Previous session, I told you I will take up the waste wear with stepped apron. But before moving to waste wear, we will discuss about the tank sluice in which pipe sluice. Okay, what is how pipe sluice is drawn? It is similar to the tank sluice head wall, gibbet wall, barrel section, but little bit difference is there that I will explain in this video. Let us take up one examination problem. Draw the following views of a pipe sluice. In tank sluice only, it is a pipe is provided instead of a barrel. Pipe is provided. Pipe sluice to the scale 1:50. 1:50 scale is given as per the details given. Okay, what we have to draw the longitudinal section through pipe, and then half plan at top and half plan at foundation. Details are given: top width of the bund 3.0 meter, front slope, upstream side slope 1.5:1, downstream slope 2:1, RL of top of bund 104.00, RL of MWL 103.00, RL of FTL 102.50, RL of sill of sluice 100.00, top width of head wall, gibbet wall and wing wall 0.5. This is the top width of head wall as well as gibbet wall and wing wall, all are given as a 0.50 meter. Bottom width of the head wall 1.2 meter. Bottom width is given. Even if it is in examination, if problem is not given the top width and all, you have to assume. Okay, these are the information given. Okay, you have to write down this problem before moving to the further slides, so that wherever I will come across the data, if I tell RL of TBL 104, you should observe from the problem. So that whatever the data given in the problem, we have to show in the drawing sheet, because each and every data carries in mass. Let us move on to the next slide. Here you can observe front side of the wing wall. Front side wing wall is a vertical. Rear side wing wall is having a slope of 1:1:6. Sometimes they may give the bell mouth width. Sometimes they may give the degree, 15 degree or 30 degree, or sometimes they may give slope. Okay, if it is not given also, you have to assume. Thickness of cement concrete bed 0.5. Below the sill level, it is a concrete is given. Plug chamber dimension is given 0.6 by 0.6 by 0.6 meter. Guide slabs are provided at 1 meter inside the chamber. We have to provide the guide slabs of 1 meter center to center. Size of the rear cistern. Rear cistern dimension is given 2.5 meter into 2.5 meter. And then height of the rear cistern wall. Rear cistern wall height is given. Sometimes it may not given. We have to assume here in this problem, height of the rear cistern is given. And then thickness of rear cistern wall. This is the thickness of cistern, means cistern wall. Wall thickness is 0.5 given. And then opening of the cistern channel. Inside the cistern channel, opening is given 0.6 meter by 0.6 meter. And then RCC pipe diameter. Hume pipe is provided. That pipe diameter is given as a 0.6 meter. Thickness of pipe. Thickness of pipe is given 5 cm and cement concrete bed of 0.2 meter. See, other places thickness of cement concrete is 0.5 meter. Previous slide what we have seen, 0.5 meter other places. Below the pipe, it is given as a 0.2 meter. And then assume missing data suitably. One more important information is given. Design the diameter of the plug hole. We have to design the diameter of the plug hole so that head of the H is given as a 0.3 meter, that is 30 centimeter. discharge is given 0.25 cubic meter per second. For this design, there may be 5 marks in the examination. Okay, out of 50 marks, they may give 5 marks. You may get this problem 35 marks. In 35 marks, 15 marks for the longitudinal section, 15 marks for the cross section, and another 5 marks may be for the design. Okay, these are the data given. From this data, any other data is required, you have to assume. Let us see how to start this drawing. First, we have to calculate the plug hole diameter. To calculate this, first assume the coefficient of discharge as a 0.6 meter. Sorry, it is not meter, it is unitless. 0.6 coefficient of discharge. And then maximum discharge Q is equal to CD A root 2GH. This is the formula for discharge through the orifice and all you have seen in hydraulics. That formula we are using, CD A root 2GH, where Q is equal to discharge required. Discharge required is given 0.25 cubic meter per second. Coefficient of discharge we are assumed 0.6. Area of the plug hole, area through which water has to be flowed, that is we have to calculate. G is 9.81 meter per second square, and h is given as a 0.3 meter. Okay, these are the data given in the problem. Next, substitute these values. 0.6 is the CD, A we don't know, question mark A. And then 2 into 9.81 into H is given in the problem, 0.3. Then if you cross multiply this with Q, Q is given, Q is 0.25, Q divided by this entire thing will go below. Cross multiplication, we will get area of the plug hole, 0.6 meter square. Then we know that area is equal to pi d square by 4, that is circular opening. We have the formula pi d square by 4. If you take as a cross multiplication, then d is equal to square root of 4a divided by pi. 4 into 0.06 divided by pi, you will get 0.27 as the diameter of the hole, plug hole, that we will round up into the 0.3 meter. This is the diameter of the plug hole, that is where we are providing the plug like this. These two stones, we are providing the plug, you know, that plug hole, we are designing the plug hole. This width is a 0.3 meter. Okay. This is 5 marks, simple calculation you should carry out. After calculating this, we will start drawing the longitudinal section of the pipe sluice. For drawing the longitudinal section, you have to draw first horizontal line at sill level. Sill level 100.00, sill level we are assumed as 100.00, and then mark FTL, FTL, MWL, FTL 102.5, MWL 103.00, and top of the bund level 104.00. All this marking you have to carry out 1:50 scale. Okay, in thin lines, you draw all these lines, thin lines, this TBL line, MWL and FTL and all. Then draw slope line. This is whatever the slope is given, 1.5:1. Okay, I have left some place here. You can draw complete line, and afterwards you can rub as per the requirement for drawing the head wall and gibbet wall. Then draw top width 3 meter. Top width of the bund 3 meter is given in the problem. Then downstream slope 2 is to 1. I have left here some space. For what purpose? For drawing the cistern. Okay. We will mark 0.5 meter above MWL. Above MWL, we will take some 0.3 height above this, so that MWL water should not enter above the MWL wave action comes. It should not enter the water inside the chamber. That is why some free board has been provided. Above this MWL, leave 0.3 meter. Then draw one horizontal line. This horizontal line, top width of the head wall, 0.5. We have to draw the horizontal line that is equal to the top width of the head wall. Normally head wall will come back side of this like this, because it has to retain this earth's pressure. For that's why we are providing this head wall. It will not allow the earth fall inside the chamber what we are providing here. Okay. Then bottom width of the head wall is given in the problem, 1.2 meter. Mark this point and draw the bottom width of the head wall. Below you have to show some dotted line, because here pipe is coming. When you see the cross section, we will not be able to see the head wall portion. We will see pipe portion. Water is flowing through the pipe. This is the head wall. And then one more point you mark here, this distance. This distance you can assume, or it may be given in the problem. Okay, this is a gibbet wall. Gibbet wall width 1 meter. We are taking length of the gibbet wall as a 1 meter. Thickness of gibbet wall is 0.5 meter. 1 meter I am taking here. After 1 meter, you draw one vertical line. Okay, we have finished the head wall and gibbet wall. Inside these two gibbet walls, we will get the plug chamber. This is the plug chamber. Next, of course, this can drawn afterwards, but you should not forget the drawing of in bed concrete. That is why I have completed some portion of the bed concrete, 0.5 thickness below the head wall, gibbet wall. And this portion is wing wall. Wing wall portion have provided the concrete of thickness 0.5. Afterwards, after this portion, you have to assume this projection. If it is given, good. Otherwise, you have to assume this projection as in 0.15 or 0.3. Same projection you have to maintain here also. Offset, concrete offset you have to take here, 0.15 or 0.2. Afterwards, you have to draw the 0.2 thickness concrete below the pipe. Okay. Up to somewhere where cistern is coming. Here rear cistern is coming. Again rear cistern, we have to increase the thickness of concrete, bed concrete, to 0.5. That is why I have left some distance, 0.2. After completing the cistern, we can finish this entire bed concrete. Then I am going to complete this plug chamber. Plug chamber 0.6 by 0.6 by 0.6 size. And then we are having in slabs, guide slabs 1 meter center to center. You have to provide the slabs, one slab, two slab, like that, 1 meter center to center you can provide slabs. The slab thickness may be 0.15, or you can take 0.2 meter thick slabs. Inside this you provide this vertical gate valve, and here it is the plug. Okay, if you lift this plug above, then water will be entering through this plug diameter plug hole, and then it will start flowing. Okay, that is the arrangement in the plug chamber. You can see how it is. It should be neatly drawn. These are all the guide slabs fixed to the gibbet wall, and this is the top slab. It is taken little bit projection inside, and this is the plug chamber. If I assume this is the 1 meter, then if you leave this point to another 0.8 is there. In that case, you have to reduce this plug chamber by providing the slab. Okay, providing inside thickness of slab, you can increase and reduce this width as in 0.6. If it is in width is taken as in 0.75, if this width is taken 0.75, then okay, if we provide this 15 centimeter thick slabs, then balance will be 0.75 minus 0.15. Here width you will get as a 0.6. okay, like that you have to make a chamber according to whatever the dimensions given. And another important point is this gap, that is the this is the one slab and another slab is here. In between gap, this gap we are calculated as in 0.3 design of plug hole. This plug hole diameter we are calculated as a 0.3. Above this we are providing this plug. Okay, fine. We have drawn the plug as well as all guides, slabs, head wall, and this connecting rod, bed concrete. You can observe, you have to draw the sketch neatly, and you should finish with all hatches, everything with dimensioning and all. Then you draw the pipe. This is the 0.6 diameter pipe is given. Start the pipe from here, this point, and you have to finish the cistern place. Okay, and also it is given 0.5 centimeter, 0.05 meter thickness of pipe is given. That means inside diameter, inside distance should be 0.6 plus 0.05, both the side thickness of the pipe. That should be shown in the drawing. After completing this pipe portion, you have to draw this rear cistern wall. This wall is given in the problem. Height of the wall is given. That height, something 1.1 meter or something is given, height of the cistern wall. That height you have to draw here, and then width of the wall is 0.5 meter. Otherwise, if height is not given, then you should complete this sloping line completely, and then continue this portion pipe. Where pipe touches, there you can take extra additional height of 0.5 where it touches the slope. Up to there you have to raise this wall, and then it should touch this portion, sloping portion. Then you can complete. Afterwards, here further you take the 2.5 meter, further 2.5 meter from this face you can take, and again another wall can be drawn. If height is given, you have to draw same height. Okay, I have completed hatching of this wall, and then further 2.5 meter is taken for the cistern portion. See, again another wall is constructed here, little bit height lesser than this height, and then joined the both walls, other two side walls will be in the form of a sloping. This is the rear cistern, 2.5 by 2.5 meter. Below this concrete bed is there, I have continued this concrete bridge here, giving in some offset here, 0.15 or 0.2 offset is given here. I have assumed 0.2 20 centimeter offset. That 20 centimeter offset you should maintain both the sides, and height is 0.5. This height is 0.5. Complete this concrete bedding also. Finally, your drawing is ready. Longitudinal section, this may be sometimes 25 marks. Very simple. You have to follow step, and of course this side you have to show the sloping line, because wing wall is there, nearest lines here, and then it should be increased so that it shows wing wall is splayed. Splayed means it is 1:6 splay is given, inclination is given. That we have to show here. This is the final drawing. Okay, next we are moving to the half planet top, half planet bottom. For that I have drawn here center line. Center line from this upstream side to downstream side. I am going to draw half planet top this side, half planet bottom left side. First we will cut the earthen bund. Earthen bund may be 1 meter, even 300 meter to 1.5 kilometer. It may be very long. In that only one small portion is the tank sluice portion. That is why I have shown the break line here. Then project the top width of the bund. Project top width of the bund. Show here top width 3 meter. I have shown RL also, don't worry, need not necessary to show the RL, only you can write the top width of the bund 3 meter. You can see how it is. This is the 3 meter top width, what is projected. Okay, afterwards you remove the projection lines. And here also you can take the projection of end of this wing wall. This is the projection line. Next, again I am projecting this gibbet wall as well as head wall portion. I have projected both the portions. Okay, this top width of the head wall, top width of the gibbet wall, both I have taken the projection to the center line of this, up to center line. Top, we will see the top width of the head wall as well as gibbet wall. Now we are taken the projection of this portion. Here you can observe, this is the plug chamber. We have to draw this plug chamber, and this is the gibbet wall. This portion is gibbet wall, this is the head wall, top width. These are the dimensions what we have taken. Top width of the gibbet wall, top width of the head wall, length of the gibbet wall, 0.75 we have taken. That is why if we provide here slab 0.15 thickness slab, then we will get the plug chamber as an 0.6, that is in longitudinal section you can observe. This is the 0.3 what we are considered here. That is the total pipe diameter is 0.6, out of which half portion we are viewing. This is the pipe, this is the thickness of pipe, this is the concrete what we are provided for the pipe. If we cut here and we are looking like this, above half planet top, half planet bottom. When we see the half planet bottom, this half cutting, this width will be 0.3. Total 0.6, 0.5 is considered here. Okay, this chamber you should carefully draw like this. This is the 0.3, 0.75, 0.5. Okay. Please watch video properly so that you will not do any mistake. Then after completing this plug chamber portion, you should draw the wing wall. Wing wall 1 in 6, take 6 like this and 1 like this, you will get one inclined line. That wing wall should stop up to end of the bund. Whatever the line you are projected here, up to there, this width of the wing wall is 0.5. It is given in the problem. Top width of the wing wall, top width of the head wall, gibbet wall and all 0.5. Of course, another one important point is we are showing the plug hole diameter. Plug hole diameter, it is shown in this sketch, it is 0.2. I think we have to make it 0.3 this portion. Okay, fine. We are corrected this 0.3 plug hole diameter, 0.3 what we calculated. This is the gibbet wall. This portion is gibbet wall. One more, this portion will be head wall. There are the two gibbet walls are there, one left side and another right side, one gibbet wall will be there. Head wall is connecting these two gibbet walls. This front side, it is open. Wing wall will guide the water to flow through the plug chamber. This is the arrangement. You can observe here, we have shown the plug hole. Another half portion, it may not be visible because half plan at bottom, we cannot see the plug hole. Okay, don't get confused which is gibbet wall and which is head wall. This is the head wall, this is gibbet wall, this is wing wall. Be clear when you are drawing the sketches. Then we are going to complete this revetment. Revetment of both sides and then along the wing wall side. This revetment should be from here you can start revetment. This is the end of slim side. Balance this portion here, slope is there. That slope is shown here. Nearest to increasing. That means slope towards in this direction. 1.5:1. Again, you can show the slope right side also. That is downstream side. Here nearest and it is increasing. That shows it is sloping in this direction. I have left some space here for drawing the cistern. Drawing the cistern, I have left the space. Next step is to draw the thickness of pipe. Thickness of pipe, when you are drawing the thickness of pipe, 5 cm, I have to show one more important point. Here, when you are drawing this thickness, first you have to draw this pipe. This pipe should be at sea level. Below sea level, you have to show the thickness. That is, this is the sea level. Below sea level, you have to show the thickness of the pipe. And this is the pipe, again thickness of the pipe. That means water should be clearly flow through this opening. It should not, thickness should not obstruct the opening. Clear opening width is 0.6. That is the important. Here also, we are shown the thickness. You can observe here. This is the thickness of the pipe. This is clear width. Whatever we are provided here, width 0.6, same maintained in this portion also. But if it is a barrel, we are showing the here barrel portion. Because pipe, only thickness of pipe is there and opening width is there. The entire setup looks like this. Then you have to draw the rear cistern. For rear cistern, take the projection of these two walls. These two walls, take the projection, complete the rear cistern. Here two walls will be up to touching the center line, because from top you can see it is touches, or even sometimes you can provide the width up to here only. And this side we have to show the opening for water flowing 0.3 after the center line. This side also 0.3, total will be 0.6. Then this connecting wall, you connect both the walls. Fine, you can observe we are almost completed the half line at top. Only hidden lines are balanced, that we can show afterwards depending upon the time availability. Now half line at bottom. For drawing the half line at bottom, again same whatever here, this is the gibbet wall portion 0.75, head wall portion 0.5, and then inclined line, that is a wing wall. You have to draw mirror of this side, and then this is the thickness of the head wall, gibbet wall, thickness of the wing wall, all are 0.5. that is why it is 0.5 shown on the half plane at top. Top you can see dotted line, because we are observing here bottom level width will be more, that is why we have shown dotted line top width. This is the complete setup of what you can observe. Then you can say this is the plug chamber. Then another 0.3 half pipe we can see. When we cut, we can see the half pipe, and here complete opening should be there, because half plane at bottom we are observing, complete opening you have to maintain. You can observe here, complete opening is there. 0.6 I have taken. In this 0.6, 0.3 center line this side, and 0.3 top half plane at top side. Total is 0.6. And then balance thickness of the pipe. Fine. Then we are going to complete the cistern portion. It is a square, that is why 2.5 this direction and 2.5 this direction. You can complete the square cistern. And here we are providing the opening 0.6 width. And this is the rear cistern. Size is 2.5 by 2.5. Thickness of wall is 0.5. Like this, you have to complete the rear cistern portion. This is the next step. We have to show the hidden lines. I have shown the hidden lines. You can observe this. For drawing the hidden lines, here I have taken complete bottom width of the wing wall, I have assumed, because it is not given in this problem. They are not given this width. This width of the bottom width of the head wall, this gibbet wall, is not given. That is why I have assumed this is straight. Previous problem and all, here junction some width is given. The junction width we are attached, and then again there may be width of the gibbet wall is given. But in this case, no data is available. I have assumed this is straight, and then we have stopped here bottom width level. Bottom width level means this is the bottom width of the head wall. Up to there we have taken the this wall portion. Okay, that same dotted line you have to show on top width side. And again another concrete projection 0.2 is there. That concrete projection dotted line also you have to show here. That is, whatever left side you are drawing, that mirror you have to show right side. Again here this portion you can observe dotted line of thickness of the pipe, and then concrete projection. This is the concrete projection 0.2. Then half planet top also we have to show the concrete as a dark line. This is the concrete projection. This will comes like this. This projection of this concrete, and then here it is concrete. Again, it will comes like this, and we have to draw complete full. Okay. Then same mirror we are showing here. This is a offset of the concrete complete. That tendril hidden line, because we cannot see from the top. And then you have to hatch this portion. This portion you have to hatch. Of course, here and all we are hatched the concrete. Same concrete will be this here and all. You have to show concrete. Here concrete, and this head wall cross section you have to show by hatching at 45 degree, one straight line, another dotted line like that. I have shown some RLs. Don't worry, don't show any RLs. Just for understanding, this is the this level. This point is at the level of bed level, and this point is at the TBL level. This is also ground level like that. I have shown. It is need not necessary to show the RLs. If time permits, you can do all those things. Now this is the final picture. You can observe. It should be looks like this. Beautifully, even don't think we have to do this in the AutoCAD only. Manually also, you should be able to write this sketch same way what is shown here. And how to mention each and every part along with the dimensioning. Proper dimensioning is very important, and neatness is very, very important, so that you will get a good marks in the examination. Have this screenshot, so that when you are drawing the sketch, you can be able to refer these details. This is the overall sketch. What you can observe, everything is fully dimensioned. This is the half plan at top and bottom. You can observe. This is also, you can take out the screenshot and take the printout, so that you can refer when you are drawing the drawing. You should be clear. There should not be any major mistakes. Major mistakes means this is the portion you should be very careful, and this rear system portion, hidden lines and all, you can write it afterwards. This major portions you have to show properly. Okay, that's the main important point I would like to discuss along with you people regarding the pipe sleeves. I think very interesting session. If you spend at least 35 to 40 minutes with this video one or two times, if you view, and again if you start drawing, when you are drawing also, if you get the any confusion, suddenly you can switch over to the video. You can refer and complete the drawing. That completes the unit 2 of irrigation and bridge drawing, in which I have done 3 types of sleeves. I have covered all the 3 types of sleeves, along with even plug sleeves as well as shutter type. And of course, I have shown one small design portion in this problem. Hopefully, you are doing good, and we will continue in the unit 3 waste wear with stepped apron in next session. Thank you. Fine.